Hi guys, and welcome to Stop 11 of our New York City Roadshow. We're here at Kravitz Wabey Gallery with Mark.
Hi, how's it going? Welcome.
Thanks. So, tell us what we're looking at right now, Mark.
So, I think you are in one of the very few shows that's actually quasi open to the public in New York City. It's a group show we opened about 2 weeks ago. It's actually real artwork, not only virtual. You can come in by making an appointment. We've had quite a few appointments a few days a week that we're here.
That's great.
Yeah, it's pretty cool, actually. I didn't know what to anticipate from people being comfortable, being not comfortable.
Yeah.
Normally I'm wearing a mask, but I thought it was better not to. And it's a mixture of work. It's some artists that we represent, some new people that we just started working with. It's painted by Allison Zuckerman, who will also have work in the booth at the
Great.
Art Fair. Jameer Edwards, who will also be in the fair.
I love this work. And I think it's
true.
Worth sort of zooming in so we can really see the detail.
It's all cut paper collage, acrylic, ink, all mounted onto canvas. It's about 6 by 8 feet. This is Teresa Cromati, who will also be in the fair with a new edition that we just published.
Oh, great!
In commemoration of the show she has at the Delaware Contemporary. This is a brand new artist who we just actually met over quarantine.
Interesting. How did you connect with the artist?
Instagram. Her name is Jade Thacker. She's young. She's shown around a little bit in group shows here and there, but this is really her first sort of more serious exposure. And we brought in about 9 or 10 paintings 2 weeks ago and ended up selling them all the week we brought them in.
Wow.
Yeah, it was interesting.
All virtually, obviously.
Not all virtually. Huh. Actually, two of the appointments of people that came into the gallery ended up buying paintings. The rest were virtual, yeah. In the back, there's a work by Saad Falwell, who also—
Oh, this is fabulous.
The booth at Aspen. If you zoom in close, you can see that it's a mixture of acrylic paint, pins—
Look at that, yeah, look at the eyes.
And collage. Yeah, they're incredibly intricate. And
wow.
They are usually images of women who have done amazing things for different Middle Eastern countries, whether it's Algeria, Iran, Iraq, Morocco, Egypt. Sometimes they're journalists, sometimes they're politicians, sometimes they're freedom fighters. But the unfortunate thing they all have in common is they, because of the governments where they lived, sometimes were tortured, put to death, or in prison, or harassed, and didn't have an easy time with things. This is a young artist who we will not have at the fair, unfortunately, because she's having difficulty with studio space because of the lockdown. Her name is Patricia Renee Thomas, and her studio is on the campus of Penn in the grad school, so everything is locked down at the moment.
So what's she doing?
She's working out of her very modest apartment and has not had an easy time getting good materials. So she's only managed to do a few sort of modest scale works. This is a piece by Erin Leanne Mitchell, who we'll also have in the art fair. And again, it's a collage, but this is more a textile collage.
Let's zoom in so we can really see that.
With acrylic paint. She's a young artist who grew up and lives in Birmingham, Alabama.
This is great.
So the group show is a bit of a snapshot of things that we'll show at the fair. And also, look, I'm happy to see people and have people come into the gallery and, you know, have some sort of normalcy. Not just sitting, you know, in our backyard talking on the phone.
You know, it's so nice today being able to visit people in person
and see art.
It's really wonderful.
I'm sure.
Well, Mark, thank you so much.
Thanks for coming by. Yeah.